Welcome again to Geometry, and today we're going to study a rotation. In this video, I want to show you some example how to do the rotation. My student in this video will see many examples, and this example can help you to do the quiz online. Remember, it's very important, remember all the rules about rotation. In the last class, we studied about the translation, reflection and rotation. This is our transformation, and these transformations are isometric transformation because the size and the shape do not change. But dilation we study in the next video. I'm going to show you in the next video some example about the dilation. Now I have to remember dilation is no isometric transformation. In the isometric transformation, the pre-image and the image are congruent figures, congruent image. Now, it's very important to remember too that you have translation. In the translation, the orientation of the pre-image and the image are the same. They do not change the orientation, but in reflection and rotation, the orientation change. Before to do the exercise, before to explain some examples, I want to remember the rules to do the rotations. When you have to do the rotation 90 degrees, you select the coordinate of the point, you flip the coordinate of the point, S is going to be Y is going to be X, now the coordinate X, and you change the sign of the coordinate X. When you do the rotation of 180 degrees, you don't flip, you only change the sign of the ordinary X and change the sign of the ordinary Y. Now, when you have to do the rotation of 270 degrees, you flip, but you change only the sign of the ordinary Y. And the rotation, when you do the rotation clockwise, you want to do the rotation 90 degrees, you use 270 degrees counterclockwise. You want to do the rotation 270 degrees clockwise, it's the same to do 90 degrees counterclockwise. The first example, I have the point -47, and I want to rotate the point -47, 90 degrees. I need to find the coordinate of the image A prime after the rotation 90 degrees. You create the table to do the rotation. Now you remember what is the rules, because it's 90 degrees, you flip the coordinates. And when you flip the coordinate now, 7 was Y, it's going to be X. -4 was X, now it's going to be Y. But you need to change the sign of the ordinary X. Now when you change the sign, 7 is positive, it's going to be negative, and the answer is -4, -7, -4. Another example number 2. Giving the point A, -5, we need to find the coordinate of A prime after the rotation 180 degrees. I create my tables, and you remember what is the rule. You don't flip. When you rotate 180 degrees, you need to flip the ordinate value. What you have to do, only you need to change the sign of the ordinate X and Y. Because you have -8 and -5, now when you change, it's A and -5, when you change the sign, now it's going to be -8 and 5. In the beginning, is A positive, 5 negative, you change the sign of both ordinated, now it's going to be -8 and 5 is negative, it's going to be positive. When you're going to rotate now 270 degrees, I have a new point A, -4, -9, -4, and I want to find the coordinate of the image A prime after the rotation 270 degrees. You create the table, and now what you have to do, remember you flip, you change the Y by X and the X by Y, but you need to change the sign of the ordinate Y. Now when you flip, -9, -4 is going to be, now you flip the ordinate, it's going to be -4 and -9. And now what you have to do, you need to change the sign of the Y ordinate. -9 now is going to be changed to positive. Now the answer is -4, 9. That's an example number three. Example number four, I have the triangles A, B, C, and I want to rotate my triangle 90 degrees. Step number one, you need to select what is the coordinate of each point. A is negative 5, 5, 3, B is 3, 4, and C is 0, 0. Because I need to rotate 90 degrees, you need to flip the coordinates and change the sign of the X. When you flip the coordinate and change the sign of the X, the negative is going to be Y, and the positive Y is going to be X, but you change the sign of the Y. Now the point is negative 5, negative 5. The same scene, you flip and change the sign of the X, and 0, 0. And when you plug in the 3 points in the coordinate system, I label the image, and I connect the point, and I have now the image of my pre-image. Another example, number 5. Now I want to do the reflection across X axis, and after that, I need to rotate 180 degrees. The coordinate of the point is the same triangle, but remember to do the reflection across the X axis, you keep the X and you change the sign of the Y. Now, when you do this, 5 in the coordinate of Y is going to be negative, 4 is going to be negative, and 0 continue to be 0. But now I need to select this image now, and this image is going to be the pre-image of the next transformation. And I want to rotate 180 degrees. What I had to do, change the sign of the X and change the sign of the Y, because this is the rules to do 180 degree rotation. You change the sign of both, it's positive and positive 5. You change the sign of the 3 is negative 3. You change the sign of 4 is 4, and 0 is 0, 0. You plug in the point of the graph, you label A prime, B prime, and when you connect, you have the final answers. This is another example. Example number 6, giving the coordinates of the quadrilateral A, B, C, D. This is the value. And you need to find the coordinate of the image, A prime, B prime, C prime, after the following transformation. First, I need to rotate 90 degrees. When I rotate 90 degrees, I need to reflect across Y equals negative X, and after that, I want to move my image 4 units left and 3 units up. You create a table with the corresponding value of the ordinated value of the pre-image. This is the coordinated points. And now the first transformation is rotate 90 degrees. You flip and change the sign of the X. And when you do this, you flip, A is going to be Y, and 0, you flip, remember, but you need to... And after to continue with this, I'm going to do the transformation completely in the first point. I need now in the second reflex across the Y equal negative X. You have to flip and change the sign above. Remember the rule reflex across Y if negative X. Y equal negative X. You flip the coordinate and change the sign above. This is the answer. And finally, I subtract 4. A minus 4 is, and add 3, and I have the image of negative A, 0. The same thing you're doing with another point, you another point, you reflect another point, you continue with applying the same rule for each point, the same rules. You flip and change the sign of the X. Now you flip and change the sign of both, and finally you subtract 4 and add 3, and at the end you have the answers. And this is the value of the image. Now this is the final answer. Now this is the image finally. Now this is the coordinate of the point. Thank you very much to see this video, and I hope that you have a beautiful day in the next quiz. Thank you. See you in the next class. Have a wonderful day. Bye.